find out what happens when you knock me out of my building.
We're feeling good, everybody!
Hey, come on now. Hey, Knock it off. Come on. Back it up. Let's go. Back it up. Separate crowd. Hey, come on. Back it up in your corner. Let's go. Come on, coach. Let's go.
The following contest is the three stages of real match. The first fall can only be won by knockout or submission. The second fall by cutter or the realization elbow. And the third fall, if needed, falls count anywhere. Introducing first, fighting out of the psych ward, weighing 230 pounds, the real Joshua Cutshaw.
My favorite part, Kevin.
Weighing 205 pounds, he is the 2016 Johnny Weaver Cup winner, Nick Richards!
All right, ring the bell!
Bell sounds, we are off and running. First time in CWF Mid-Atlantic history, three stages of real. Joshua Cutshaw, the real, one-on-one against Nick Richards. Very unique rules in this one. It's the best two out of three falls, Cecil Scott. Fall number one can only be won by submission or by knockout.
Yeah, submission or KO, and it's... I kind of feel like this structure really favors Joshua Cutshaw, to be honest. We'll see. We know what Richards has decided, but I feel like Cutshaw put this together knowing what he was doing.
Cutshaw is an interesting individual.
He's not playing with a full deck.
He's not, but there is a cerebral element to what he does. When he cashed in the golden ticket against Trevor Lee, he made rules that would favor him. In this challenge to Nick Richards tonight, he made rules that would favor him. For someone who is clearly so unbalanced, there is a very cerebral aspect to his game.
You ever watch one of those documentaries about serial killers, and you see them in prison, and you hear them speak, and they're almost frighteningly intelligent, but you know there's a psychopath bubbling under that brain? That's what Cutshaw reminds me of.
Cutshaw runs right through Richards.
Nick!
Submission or knockout only in the first fall.
And you go back about a year ago when we first saw Cutshaw.
Went for the elbow. That realization elbow has knocked Richards out in the past.
I went on record as saying that I feel like Cutshaw was the guy that just needed that one win. And I feel like last time these two faced, he got that one win.
That these two are one and one. Richards defeated Cutshaw on episode number 85, taking Matthews, North Carolina. He lost the return match on episode 93 back at the Omega Bowl. Of course, Cutshaw made his CWF Mid-Atlantic debut, defeating Donnie Dollars on episode number 54. Quickly went on to win Battle Bowl 2016 and the Golden Ticket on episode 57. And he cashed in that Golden Ticket on episode number 71 against Trevor Lee in a Mid-Atlantic title climax.
Oh, man, what a pump kick.
Huge pump kick. So these two are one and one. This three stages of real, as Cutshaw calls it, will ideally settle this dispute. Of course, Richards, one of the favorite sons of CWF Mid-Atlantic, survived the Cage of Death on episode number 29, went to war with the Kamikaze Kid, culminating in that Last Man Standing match on episode number 59. The most brutal match in CWF history?
Yeah, it's, if not that, then the dog collar match maybe, but it's up there. Oh!
Richards then fought through the entire Weaver Cup tournament, beating Eric Royal in the finals on episode number 67. Richards has got a guaranteed Mid-Atlantic title match in his back pocket, Cecil Scott. He has not used it to date.
Right, he's gone on record to say he doesn't think he's ready to challenge Trevor Lee yet.
Swing and a miss. Cutshaw trying to knock Richards out. Richards is trying to take him to the mat and wrestle him. Richards, in recent months, has tried to reinvent himself as a pure wrestler. We have seen Trip Cassidy verbally say he's going to drag Nick Richards back down into the depths of deathmatch wrestling. Cutshaw, to your point, looking like he's trying to drag Richards into a fight here.
And it might be happening here.
Richards will try to wrestle. Richards steps the leg in. Richards will try to go for the submission here.
Yeah, looks like a sharpshooter.
He could lay down for the figure four. He could turn over for the sharpshooter.
This was a favorite hold of one of his mentors, Corey Edsel.
Cutshaw's got those long legs. I don't think Richards has got him like he wants him. Cutshaw's got those long arms and legs.
He had a really hard time manipulating Cutshaw over. Really couldn't get the hold like he wanted.
He's got one leg, but yeah, Cutshaw. You don't talk, ooh, he hit the post hard. We don't talk about reach advantage in wrestling a lot. When you've got somebody that's built like Joshua Cutshaw, it can make a big difference.
Yes, absolutely. I've mentioned it a couple times with guys like Elijah Evans and Eric Andrews, guys that really use reach. And reach doesn't just mean having long striking ability. And we'll come back to it. It looks like he's going to load up that elbow. He's gone for it a couple of times.
Trying for the realization. He beat Richards with this hold a few weeks back. Richards trying to wrestle. Leg trip, center of the ring.
Cattle mutilation.
He's got the arms trapped. If he can lock the hands, he'll have him. The hands are locked. Cutshaw's trapped. Cutshaw gave it up. Richards wins the first fall by submission. It was technical wrestling that won it for him. Cecil Scott, do you think Cutshaw was willing to sacrifice that first fall?
Man, I don't know. It seemed like he wanted to KO Nick Richards on more than one occasion.
Look at Cutshaw. Cutshaw visibly discouraged on the outside. Cutshaw says, I gotta win two more now. Cutshaw has almost seems to like the fact that his back is against the wall now.
Right, he knows if he wins this next fall, he's got a Falls Count Anywhere match, which I feel like that's exactly what he wanted, so maybe you're onto something.
I almost wonder if it's like those people that wait till the last minute to cram before the test. Cutshaw realizes that now he has to win the next two. There's no safety net of that first fall. We talked earlier about the cerebral game of Joshua Cutshaw. Both men must be ready to start the fall. Referee Kevin Pierce on his ready. We're off. We are off and running. This one can only end in the cutter or the realization elbow.
All right, and part of me wonders if he has something up his sleeve for this second fall.
Richards avoided it. Whatever he was going to try.
Cutter,
no, he's too close to the ropes. Cutshaw can use the ropes there. Leg lariat, cut him in half.
And let's not forget the cutter was kind of Nick's undoing last time these two faced.
This fall, yes, go ahead.
He went for that move and got blasted in the back of the head by that elbow.
This fall can only end in either of the way that these two men have beaten each other in the past. Richards defeated Cutshaw with the cutter on episode number 85 of CWF Worldwide. Cutshaw defeated Richards with the realization elbow on episode number 93. The second fall of this 2 out of 3 falls match can only end in the way that you have beaten another man before in this rivalry. Cutshaw made the challenge. I almost wonder if it's a matter of pride, saying you will not get me with that cutter a second time.
Right. I'm having a hard time trying to figure out what Cutshaw's end game is here. I kind of play armchair psychologist out here sometimes and try to get inside the head of these guys, but I'm not sure I want to get in the head of Cutshaw. But obviously he's got something he wants to get out of Nick Richards. And I feel like it's more than just trying to turn him back into a deathmatch wrestler. It can't be just that.
No. We have seen Trip Cassidy try to pull the devil out out of Richards in the past. I don't think Cutshaw, quite frankly, is that cerebral. Cutter, no! Oh, stuck him with it! Fall number two! Cutshaw out of nowhere with fall number two with the realization elbow the same exact way that Richards got beat before. Cutshaw takes fall number two with the realization elbow, and Richards is hurt. Richards is down in a heap.
And he kind of just made our point that we tried to make earlier about reach. Richards was getting away from Cutshaw, and he was able to reach out and grab the back of the trunks, it looked like, and pull him back in.
I don't know if our cameras are picking it up. There's real concern in the eyes of referee Kevin Pierce. Both men must get back to their feet. Both men must show themselves willing to continue before Pierce can start the third fall. And now we've got falls count anywhere, Cecil Scott, if Richards can get back up.
Right, we know Pierce, he wears his heart on his sleeve. He'll stop a match if he feels like he has to. And Richards, I don't know if he's all there right now. Pierce calls for the bell. We've got a third fall. Low bridge, and out goes Cutshaw. We've got a third fall. And this thing could go all over the Mid-Atlantic Sportatorium. Richards slides in with the baseball slide. Richards apparently has his bearings more in tune than I thought he did. Going for the dive.
Oh, into the first row they go. Reckless abandon. Everyone, please steer clear of these lunatics.
It is a sick crash of those chairs. All right.
Oh, God.
Man, that'll burn the eyes.
Trip Cassidy spoke as recently as earlier in this broadcast about bringing the animal back out in Nick Richards. Oh. In this Falls Count Anywhere match, will Richards have to do whatever it takes to survive? Will Trip Cassidy accidentally get his wish?
It might. It's Falls Count Anywhere, but there's no rule that says you got to go out and fight all over this building. A lot of guys get it in their head if it's Falls Count Anywhere that they got to brawl and go all over the place. You can just as well just wrestle in the ring like a normal match, but Richards, it's like that switch gets flipped.
Mm-hmm. Firing away on Cutshaw on the far side of the building.
Yeah, it's like the lost cause hears those magic words.
The Mid-Atlantic Sportatorium becomes almost like a playground.
It really does. And I've got a little first-hand experience. I once battled Nick Richards in a street fight, a tag team street fight. And it really is. Like, you see him in the back when he's not being a jerk like he was for 3 years. He's an affable guy. He's really easy to talk to. You get him in a match like this, he's like an animal.
Richards is stacking chairs up on the far side. This does not bode well for anyone.
I've seen this before.
Richards going back to that place.
Bang, bang, bang! Bang,
bang, bang! Bang, bang! He's got Cutshaw right where he wants him.
Through the cactus. Richards make up for that cactus up, but no, Cutshaw up. Cutshaw up and just basically shoelace tackled him.
Man, this open palm strike him in the gut. That was very effective.
Oh, dear.
Oh, no, no.
Oh, what a crash.
What a sickening thud. There's no good way to land on that.
A horrible crash. Two. Referee Kevin Pierce says only two.
Yeah, Richards somehow got up from that.
Cutshaw has got fire in his eyes. Ow! Again on the chairs.
You know, I've compared Nick Richards in the past to Arturo Gatti some years ago.
Cover! Cover!
Oh, ooh, that was close.
2-2.
I mentioned it, Gatti. He went from this blood and guts warrior, tried to become a refined boxer until he ran into a guy named Mickey Ward and had possibly the most brutal fight of all time. And this is what I'm seeing right now. Richards has met his Mickey Ward, and that fight is coming out of him, whether he wanted to or not.
Cutshaw calls himself the real says in a world of pretenders and would-be's and wannabes, he's the real deal.
So far, keeping it real has not gone wrong for him here.
Chairs being drug into the ring here. Richards is hurt. Hold on here. Oh, right in the sternum. That'll crack a rib. That'll affect your ability to breathe. That will affect your ability to do damn near anything.
I got a little bit of fear. I wondered if maybe Cutshaw knew how apprehensive Richards would be in a fight like this, and knew this was the best way to kind of win that rubber match, to get his revenge, you know, to say, hey, I'm better than Richards. Because at the end of the day, Richards is a top contender right now. You knock off a top contender, you become a top contender.
Oh, God!
So I'm wondering if that's the calculation in Cutshaw's mind right now. I could be way off base, but I think there might be something there.
Get to the brawl as quick as possible.
Yeah, get to the brawl because he knows Richards doesn't want to fight like this. It feels like maybe it's an easier path to victory.
Let's go, Nick.
Oh, dear.
Man, we saw Nick, he tried to use the chairs outside the ring, but we're not seeing that animal that fought Kamikaze Kid a year ago. What in the world? Oh, Richards is up, though.
And he tumbles to the floor.
That was almost a nasty, nasty spill. And what in the world?
Richards trying to use the ropes to his advantage here. Could be a superplex, perhaps.
That double underhook maybe off the top.
Oh, he loves that butterfly suplex, does Richards.
And look underneath the two bodies.
Oh, and the chair. Look at the hook in Cutshaw's eyes. The spine and the tailbone crashed against the chair. Cover. Two. No, sir.
And that chair blasted him right in the kidneys on the way down, too. So much damage.
Good Lord. What a damn fight we are seeing on our 100th episode. We thank you wherever you are in the world for joining us tonight. Episode 100.
Cutshaw trying to create some distance. But he's not safe out there.
No, falls literally count anywhere. There's no place. Oh, that you're safe. Richards just kicked him in the nose. That'll water your eyes. That could break your nose. That's dangerous. That's violent.
Oh, man. Cutshaw had a little bit of time.
Oh, dear.
Watch out, Pierce.
Oh, good Lord. Richards takes a tumble into the concrete. We got to keep the fans back.
I'm not really sure what happened there, but Pierce almost was in the line of fire.
We got to keep the civilians back.
Just like that, man. Cutshaw, I can't believe after that drop on the chair, he's back in the driver's seat.
Almost like that woke him up.
Right.
Got him back in this fight. Cutshaw, with evil intentions in his eyes, charges Richards.
Man, it's got a head of steam. No form, just blasted him.
No form is right. Just blunt force trauma.
And that's honestly, you go back to that Weaver Cup final, that's something Eric Royal used very effectively. He didn't come out on the winning end, but when he got a little more formless, it was very effective against Richards, ironically enough. And I'm wondering if this is just a fight maybe Richards can't win.
Cutshaw be willing to go further than Richards.
Yeah, for Richards to win this, honestly, I feel like he has to sell himself out here.
He's got to revert back to the devil that Chip Cassidy has been trying to pull out of him. At this point, I almost feel like Cutshaw is trying to pull that devil out of him. Or maybe you're right. Maybe Cutshaw feels like that deathmatch Nick Richards is dead and gone, and Cutshaw feels like he can win this fight. He is throwing chairs down on the concrete. Joshua Cutshaw is throwing chairs down on concrete. It does not get more real
than
that.
This is the game you want to play, Nick.
Let's go, Nick.
This is the game.
Get out, Nick.
It's real.
Sometimes you talk too much.
That's the game.
Richards fights up. One thing Richards will never lose is that heart.
Good Lord, he is just drilling Cutshaw, but the real Joshua Cutshaw refuses to go down.
And winds up in another big right hand, may have broken his own hand there.
Hit him again.
Yeah, you keep punching guys on the top of the head, that's bound to happen. All right, he sucked it up though, man, right on those chairs.
Crashes into the steel.
As if concrete's not bad enough.
Good Lord, Cutshaw's back on his feet!
Holy Jesus!
Like the killer from a horror movie, he pops right back up!
Man, this guy, I don't know what's going on in that head of his, but holy crap.
We have speculated about different people throughout the history of our sport, Cecil Scott, that quite frankly seem to get off on pain.
Right.
Cutshaw, I don't want to be too speculative, but Cutshaw may be proving himself to be one of those people.
Man, I don't think there's a maybe about it.
He is beating Richards down and mocking this hometown crowd.
Man, after that exchange, I really have to go back to my other question. Can Richards win this fight? Yeah, he's biting the man in the face. That'll help.
Oh, man. Going up into bleachers, that's real dangerous.
Very dangerous. There's really no good footing.
Oh, man, they're going up in the stands here. Civilians have got to stay back. They are up in the stands. That's hard wood and concrete underneath it. And a pile of chairs on top of the concrete.
And it's very easy to slip, break an ankle. It's maybe even worse up there. Oh no, he's pulling that pad down.
They look for the realization. Oh God, he hit the wall! Oh my God, he hit the wall!
And I'm gonna tell you right
now. Oh God! Crashed! Richards hooked the cutter and they crashed off the top of the bleachers down to the floor! Richards yanked Cutshaw straight to the concrete!
He
got him! Jesus Christ!
My Lord, what a fight! Richards, I said he had to sell out. He kind of did, but he did what he had to do to survive this thing. What the hell?
And your winner.
Oh my God.
Nick Richards! This is the Nick Richards I want. This is the Nick Richards you all deserve. Nick, if you're ever gonna be the man around here, if you're ever gonna be a champion, you gotta bring out the devil in you. Nick, I've been saying from day one, sinners never sleep. When the devil inside you wakes up, I swear I'll be here to see it.
The blue-eyed devil, Trip Cassidy, trying to awaken the devil inside Nick Richards.
The winner of the last bout, two falls to three, Nick Richards.
Awesome.
Yeah.